the YouTube, welcome to Cafe Enoma and welcome to our reactions to three songs in this one video. These are for our patron Dan. Our the band that we are going to begin this reaction set with is Triumph and the song Magic Power. This is our first time listen to Magic Power by Triumph. We have reacted to Triumph in the past as well, and I like them as band.
We are going to react to two other songs of the same patron in this session. In this video also, maybe Collective Soul and the song Gel of theirs, and TNT Seven Seas. TNT, wow, interesting name. Collective Soul we have reacted to once before, months ago.
Yeah.
Triumph we've reacted to a few times. TNT should be new unless their full forms mean some artists we have heard before. Let's get started with the first one, Triumph, Magic Power. Should be interesting.
Thank you.
What are your thoughts?
Wow, this is a great song by Triumph. This is a meaningful, very simple, very, very simple song, very simple lyrics, but extremely meaningful. And, you know, giving across the message of the power of music on individuals, on people, on the listeners, how effective it is, and the essence of music in such simple words and with such simple music.
It's just so beautiful. It is just amazing to listen to songs like that. So inspiring. Talks about the power of music.
Magic of
in,
music.
In three or four different ways. Beautifully written, beautifully
well
sung.
Written.
Wonderful music. It's so uplifting and inspiring. And that's what good music does.
Yes.
And great music goes beyond that. This is great music. It's not just good. It's beyond good. It's great. This is wonderfully put together. Talking about the girl, talking about the guy, talking about everybody in general. Everyone's mood, spirit, people who are chasing their dreams, people who are feeling down and out, people who are having a bad day. They turn on the radio, they listen to Triumph, they listen to music that they love, and the whole world is turned upside down in a good way.
In a good way.
You know, it's suddenly everything changes. Their lights flicker, so to speak, in their brain. It's a mood uplifter. It's inspiring. It's upbeat. It makes them feel so better, so much better all of a sudden. You know, it happens so quickly. Good music, great music has the power to change lives. It can change the world, but it can also change lives first. To change the world, you need to change lives. And that's what good music and great music does. So this is very inspiring music. To listen to it tells you the power of music, and there are not too many songs which can be
actually
as inspiring and uplifting as this. You do hear a few of them off and on. Today we heard one, you know, about love just before this. Actually,
Love is the Answer.
Love is the Answer
by Todd Rundgren.
Yeah, an unknown artist. We have not heard
for
of him
us,
ever.
Yeah.
But what a phenomenal song and inspiring. One of the best final verses of a song I've ever heard. Or at least in the this
very
year,
well written, yeah.
Last 365 days. This was another brilliant song. I enjoy the music of Triumph. They have a lot of inspiration and similarities to Rush.
The this Canadian, one I would say
the Canadian cousin.
Again.
But as far as lyrics go, this one's so powerful. Really, yeah. Really powerful.
Yeah.
You know, and this is not the first time. We've reacted to very few songs of Triumph, to be honest.
So far, yeah.
But every single time,
it's
either with the music or with the lyrics, they have really showcased how phenomenal they are as a band, as a rock band, as a set of
musicians.
They're
a good team. Very good team. And when you take inspiration from someone, you should take the right inspiration. When it comes to taking inspiration from Rush, not only the music of Rush was good, but also they were always, always, always focused on good lyrics. And
yeah,
that is a hallmark of Triumph as well. They also try to focus on the lyrics, just not throw anything and try to make sense of it or just do weird things with lyrics. They make sense when they write lyrics.
Well, if that's the case, why isn't Triumph well known?
I don't know what is wrong with Rush.
You know, Rush also, they have the ups and downs. You know, whenever we talk about reactions, of course, Rush is a legendary Canadian rock band. But,
yeah.
You know, are they really well known in the world?
Not so much
really
as
well
the other bands from USA.
Yeah, or even UK. You know,
or
not,
UK, yeah.
They're definitely no Pink Floyd.
They are.
Not as well known as Pink Floyd.
Yeah.
Or not as well
for
known
popularity.
As the Rolling Stones. Not as well known as the Beatles. Definitely not. What is the reason for Triumph though? Since we are on Triumph, let's keep aside Rush. Rush definitely has a vast catalog and long history, and we know that because we've reacted to so much of their music. What about Triumph? You know, they sound as good as any big band we've heard or big artist we've heard. What's stopping them from being known? I mean, Rush, okay, you can understand. They are known.
Yeah.
But Triumph is not even known worldwide.
Not so much.
I don't think people in India have even heard of Triumph.
No.
And people in India do hear a lot of music.
A lot of music, yeah.
You know, there is a vast amount of our population, maybe 10%. But that 10% is equivalent to what? 100 million or more? So you're talking about 100 million people, three times the population of Canada. Who's heard a lot of good music.
Yeah.
Rock music, pop music from the West. From all around the world. So why haven't they ever heard Triumph? And possibly they haven't, because I have interacted enough with people from my country and even other countries to know that people have not heard about Triumph.
Having the family members themselves being always appreciative of music and
Triumph has never come across. Yeah. Never ever.
There is a flaw in the system where you know the reach of these musicians is restricted.
Yeah.
The way they should be sent out, the way they should be exported is restricted. I don't know what is that politics is all about. Just like I see a lot of politics in our reactions going to people. I don't understand that. Just because Triumph is from Canada, they aren't mentioning Canada in their songs. So why are they restricted to one nation? This music was universal. Music is universal. Music is everyone's property. And so Triumph's music, it was so neutral, and so universal. Why is it not allowed to reach people?
Especially a song like this on the power of
power music. Power of music.
That's it for this one though. We'll move to the next one very quickly.
Yeah.
We have another,
Collective Soul, yeah.
Another big band which we have not heard much of.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, due to the algorithms of what.
It's all about promotion.
But let's
promotion.
Hear the song and see why. Let us see if it's the same case as Triumph, that it's a great song. But for some reason, they are not heard of much around the world. They certainly are no Pink Floyd, and they certainly are no Beatles.
For popularity.
Or Rolling Stones, or Def Leppard, or so many other bands, you know, Lynyrd Skynyrd, and so many. Even Lynyrd Skynyrd, for that matter, is not known much.
Not much in India.
In Asia. All of Asia.
Asia also.
You go to Thailand, no one's heard of them.
Yeah.
Maybe apart from Sweet Home Alabama because of the movie. Yeah. Let's get started.
Yes.
With this next one. Quick break and we'll be back. 8 seconds or less.
Namaste YouTube. Welcome to Cafe Enoma and welcome to our first time single take. Honest reaction to the song Gel. It's a song by Collective Soul. And let's get started with the music right away.
Yeah, maybe we'll have something to discuss like the last song. If you've not caught the last reaction, chances are you
Why
may have
you
gone
not?
Through it. Watch it in its entirety. The music was phenomenal and our discussion also may be thought-provoking, especially if you're from Canada or elsewhere in the world, apart from
and you're
US,
a fan of Triumph,
apart from US and UK, you know, and a couple of other countries, you will get what we are talking about.
Tongue to share. Tell me how you love to hate me.
time, gel. Well, how relevant it is to the title that they chose for the song, Let's Gel. I knew that was coming.
Entertaining, entertaining, pulsating rock music here. Presented to us by Collective Soul. Wow.
Collective Soul.
This is the band name is Collective Soul. What do you expect? It's all about gelling together.
It's been a while anybody has, you know, we react to a lot of music, but rarely we come across topics like this taken up by the bands. Let's gel, color me anything you want, do what you like with me, change me, don't change me, but I want to mingle.
I want to be with you. Basically,
jungle.
I'm willing to change, I'm willing to do what it takes, I'm willing to color myself, do anything. You know, I'm willing to do anything as long as we gel, as long as we mix together, as long as we live together, as long as we live in harmony.
Yeah.
This is a beautiful song. When we talk about there's so much discrimination and racism still existing in the world today.
I know.
And you know, you would think that social media and technological advancements and social networking apps would actually help reduce it. It has actually increased it tenfold.
It has.
So, you know, discrimination is literally, even in friend circles now it happens. It may not be just color discrimination. It may be brand discrimination, you know, profession discrimination, age discrimination, gender discrimination, race discrimination, faith discrimination, religious discrimination, and so many other discriminations, kinds of discrimination. So this is a perfect song, you know, no matter what race we are, what color, what anything, we just should gel together. This is what I want to gel with you. It may be primarily talking about one person, but if you look at it,
I think it's about people as well. He wants to mingle with people. He wants to get, he wants to be part of the action and part of the people wherever he is going. Or do whatever you want to do with me. You know, there was this movie Jim Carrey is there. They are aliens. They come on Earth.
Yeah.
And
Earth girls are easy.
Earth girls are easy. They want to gel well on this planet. That movie and this song put them together. It would be like match made in heaven. The plot of that movie and this song, literally, I don't know how, but I remember that movie. It's been a long, long, long time ago that I watched it. But it's a very beautiful movie. And this song for that, it's, I'm talking about aliens mixing up with people on Earth. We aren't aliens. But we also find it very, very, very difficult to gel well.
Yeah, the Collective Soul seems to be a band of this decade as
well. I like the bass, by the way.
So they are the band of this decade, very current.
Yeah.
Okay. Still not a very old band like many of the bands. Yeah, that's what I was trying to check.
Okay.
Didn't get too much info because obviously it will take too long.
Don't want to do that anyway.
Yeah. So just, it seems to be that they are around from the 90s and now possibly still active now.
Big bang music here, and I like the vocals. And for the topic, what do I say? You know, the biggest musician of this era and the century gone by, Mr. Michael Jackson, had to color the, literally change the color of his face to gel well. He may have felt that kind of feeling almost constantly.
Maybe.
To
we
have
don't,
done that.
We don't really know what's the
I don't know
what is.
What really prompted him to do that, but he did something very
definitely
radical.
Definitely there was a lot of discrimination, and even though he was considered the king of pop at that time, I don't think he was treated like the king of pop.
Yeah. He was constantly being sabotaged and, you know, dragged down. And no matter what his music,
even till today,
how loud his music
even till today, even though he's been cleared of the child.
Yeah. I mean, he's dead and gone. And his music has to live on. Yeah.
All those allegations, nobody really talks good about him. You know?
No one wants to accept that he was a legend.
When he did so much good in his life and such great music, such variety in his music, and he was a phenomenal performer, one of the best dancers in the world. But people have just
inspiration
kind of
for
forgotten
billions
him,
of
forgotten
people.
The good side of him, the music in him. They've forgotten all that and they choose to remember only other things. And that's unfortunate because, you know, the others, for obviously because of such reasons, they are remembered. They are remembered a lot more than him. and in a good way. Even they may have done a lot of bad things in their life. Some bad. They're not that not that any of those allegations have been proven in a court of law.
I mean, and not that we can decide whether it was right or wrong, but it's about the music and the musician, it's about the
discipline. Either way, he's been scot-free. He was,
the
allegations were dropped, and in fact, two of the kids who actually came forward, they said they lied. So it's, that's what the documentary later showed.
Okay.
That they realized that they actually...
They were playing around with things?
Yeah, they were doing it on their parents or lawyers or the one of those documentary makers' request. To get a lot of money under the table.
Oh, that happens
too. Or as a settlement.
This is the world. Yeah, that happens too. Anyway, this was fun. This is fun to react to gel. Very enjoyable. One song.
Yeah. Well, let's move to the last song, TNT, and the song Seven Seas.
TNT.
First time ever, I think.
First time, yeah. For me too.
In my life, TNT. Should be interesting.
Namaste YouTube, welcome to Cafe Enoma and welcome to our first time single take honest reaction to TNT and the song Seven Seas. I hope you enjoyed the earlier two reactions of ours, one to Triumph and the other one to Collective Soul. Now this is the time for TNT, the first time we are going to listen to TNT on the request of our patron Dana.
Yeah, I certainly enjoyed the first song. The second song was enjoyable too, but easily for me the winner is... Song number one.
Triumph. Okay.
Yeah, it's a masterpiece. It's a masterpiece. It's very inspiring. It's still lingering in my mind. Even though there was a song after that.
We'll be right back.
song, very good song, good metal music, good vocals, good
vocals clean, are vocals. Crazy of his. Whoever has sung this, he reminds me of Timo Tolki's projects and his kind of music. King Diamond like voice here we heard on display. And Michael Kesk like.
But the lyrics were the weak link.
Oh, the lyrics
especially
were nothing
when you
actually.
Try in the same session and then Collective Soul.
Yeah.
Your kind of the weak link was the lyrics.
Lyrics I would say was zero actually.
Yeah. So yeah. We are rulers of the world, rulers of the seven seas. And all that, okay, maybe it's a
fantasy,
historical topic.
Yeah.
Fantasy,
I would
like
say fantasy
subject.
Or fiction.
Yeah, anyone who thinks they are rulers of the world and unless they are the gods, I think
it's
pure fantasy.
Yeah, it's fantasy writing.
Good music though.
Very
good,
good
music.
Music
and
I like the bass
nice
guitar
vocals.
And the music. The drums also when it was done on the cymbals, that was a highlighting moment in the music. The bass guitar playing, the drums on the cymbals and everything working for the song. I enjoyed his vocals a lot. He has a wide range to offer and variety in his vocals. He could easily and effortlessly change to falsetto, to normal, to mid-range somewhere. Very, very rich vocals from him. I don't know
we'll
who
have
is
to,
it.
We'll have to listen to more of them to make an assessment, a proper assessment of their music.
Yeah.
Because this, as far as lyrics go, it was quite shallow. We can analyze the music, yes, it made us feel good.
Yeah.
It was well sung, beautifully sung in fact.
Yeah.
Strong point for me is certainly the vocals of the lead vocalist here.
Mm-hmm.
Definitely enjoyed it, especially when he took those high notes, hit those high notes, that was just marvelous to listen to. So that's definitely the strong point for me, based on this first listen. First time ever in my life, I think I'm hearing them.
TNT
and this song. But yeah, because of the lyrics, I don't feel I'm ready to make a proper assessment of them. It would be unfair. Because as I have done in the past, I would say it's not my cup of tea. Because whenever lyrics are weak, being a lyrics guy, definitely I connect more with lyrics. If the music is weak, definitely I connect more with the lyrics and look for connections there. But in this case, the music was strong, so I'll overlook the lyrics for now. But maybe a second listen or a second song of TNT would definitely be the right time to make a proper assessment of them.
Mm.
What about you? Anything you'd like to share about the lyrics? What do you think it's about? Or anything else before we wind up?
For me, the lyrics were really childish. It was about we are the kings of the seven seas, we are ready to fight and this, that. But it's childish. The way of writing was childish. With the music being that mature and the vocals being of such a high range and high level, I would have liked lyrics to stand out for the band so that it does a good service for the band and they craft their work. Because this is not what a person will remember them for. There are a lot of bands from that side, from European side, that we hear with similar kind of music, as well as great vocals, but lyrics will something will be setting you apart.
Are they talking about the English Navy or the army?
I don't know. We reacted
or the
to,
conquerors, the colonies.
We reacted to Victoria.
Colonizers.
Today we reacted to Victoria by the Kings, and that was a proud song for any Englishman to talk about Victoria in her glory. I don't know if this was related to it, but it wasn't saying one region, one place, anything. It was general lyrics, but you know, way of writing it is very, very light, very, very light. Not much put into it, just put the lines together, what rhymes or something like that and put it out. A little bit work on the lyrics and this song would definitely stand out.
Yeah, it was more or less repetitive also. It was very limited, maybe 16 to 20 lines, which is quite limited for a four-minute song.
So TNT can only make a mark with very good lyrics, with
so
music like that.
They
and
needed
vocals.
More lyrics clearly in this one. Definitely the weak link of this band. If this is how it is in other songs also, definitely sad.
Sad for them.
Sad for them, yeah, not for us. We enjoy the music.
I like the music, yeah.
We are music lovers, so even though it's a song that may not be to the, you know, my liking.
We hear a lot of
liking,
lyrically charged songs as well.
We enjoy
so
it, but at the
okay.
same time, we are here to give a review. We are not here just to listen to music. We are reactors.
We are reacting as well.
We are reviewing it. As counselors, teachers, life coaches, as well as music lovers from another nation, from another side of the world to most music that we hear. Definitely. And definitely. TNT, I would like to learn more about them. But definitely, I'd like to listen to the Triumph song a few more times tonight.
Mm.
That is the one that made the most
magic impact, power,
the greatest impact on me today. So on that note, we'll take a break for a cup of tea. You too can enjoy a cup of tea. During your tea break, if you'd like to learn a bit about us or request a reaction, you could obviously check out our Patreon page. The link is in the description box of this video. And in the description box is also a brief description of us and our channel. So that will give you a little bit of an idea. If you're short on time, you can just run through it. That's it for now. Goodbye.